So with these few words, I welcome you all to our media briefing, and then I would also love to call the PC to take the podium and talk to your people, please.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, media. I'm principally here to address the media practitioners whom I have cordially invited to this event, and through them to try and inform our public out there and the rest of the international community on the state of affairs with regard to the lawsuit that we have filed against the mighty Federal Republic of Germany in our search for restorative justice. As you know, we are scheduled to travel to the United States next week, Tuesday, for the resumption of the court hearing in New York before the Honorable Judge Swain to see what will transpire in the next round of this conference. Last week, Friday, before I come there, I was alerted that there's an interesting headline in one of the local papers saying that of a Herrero Nama lawsuit in limbo. And I'm perplexed by it. What limbo? So, I haven't read the story, but the headline obviously suggests some serious stories behind the headline. But then, I don't know which newspaper it is, but clearly it must be one of those that benefits from German development aid to Namibia.
Yes.
Without knowing which newspaper it is. That's the conclusion that one can come to. Our case is not in limbo against Germany. Our case is progressing exceptionally well. I think that headline was probably informed by this half page press release that was issued by a German chief propagandist here in Namibia, which basically purport to say something without saying something. Let us leave it at that. Ladies and gentlemen, as you know, up to now, Germany has always said it will not come to New York. It will not go to New York. It will not go to court because it is a sovereign, independent state. And as far as Germany is concerned, as an independent sovereign state, it will not be dragged to court by small boys like the Namas and the Hereros in a foreign state, period. We always maintain the position that Germany can run, but Germany cannot hide. And one day, the long arm of the law will catch up with Germany, and it will have to face us in court, right there in New York, in the United States. kicking and screaming. Last week, in preparing for the deadline in terms of the court rules that after 60 days, if we don't hear from Germany, we are entitled to file for a motion for default judgment. Meaning that if Germany does not file a motion that they will defend the case, that they will appear in front of court, represented by a lawyer, we, amongst other options, can file for a motion that the court orders that we be given judgment as requested, namely that Germany has committed an act of genocide against our ancestors, which is a crime against humanity in terms of international law. That Germany has illegally confiscated our ancestral lands that used to belong to our ancestors. All the lands, virtually two-thirds of Namibia, as you know, used to be inhabited by Herero and Nama peoples, our fathers and mothers. And as of today, would have been our inheritance. We would have been living on those lands, which today are the private commercial farms of the children of those German settlers who came here and were then expropriated through legislation by the German colonial occupation forces. Thirdly, we charge Germany with illegally having expropriated the livestock and other properties of our ancestors without compensation. Ladies and gentlemen, Germany has no defense to all these charges, and they know it. These are historical facts. And we are not surprised, and we will not be surprised, that Germany would rather shy away from the lights of television cameras in an open court in New York, because the entire international press would be there, to try and defend itself against these charges. And the eminent historians of international repute, as well as legal experts of international repute, that we have lined up to testify and to bring to the fore the brutal colonial records of German ruling class of that time. Germany can only try to stay away. That's the only defense they have. But then they realize that when I instructed the lawyers to file a motion for default judgment, what it actually means. Basically, it means that court listens to our submission, which will be powerful, convincing, and unassailable. We are confident the court will grant that motion. And we'll basically end up being handed over a blank check to fill in the zeros, as many as we want to, in terms of the reparation we are asking. And that's when Germany started to smell the coffee and realized that for them to stay away from the court in New York is basically to sign their own death warrant and to bankrupt the German state. That's when, last week, they instructed, they resolved to instruct lawyers in the United States, in Washington, to actually represent them in court on the 25th of January next week, when we appear in New York. So, contrary to what the chief propagandist of Germany here in Namibia is saying, that they don't appear in courts in foreign jurisdictions, and which is echoed by their local propaganda pamphlet there, saying that our case is in limbo and Germany will not be in court next week. Ladies and gentlemen, I have a communication here written last week, Thursday, by a Mr. Jeffrey Harris, eminent lawyer, in Washington, instructed by the Federal Republic of Germany, writing to Counsel of the Namasen Yovahereros in New York, Mr. McCallion, saying the following. Mr. McCallion, we represent the Federal Republic of Germany. We are filing a motion to dismiss for lack of subject matter jurisdiction and are seeking your consent to the relief requested. Would you believe that? We want our consent. While I recognize that this is a fool's errand, nevertheless, the rules require that I consult with you before filing. We plan to file tomorrow, so please respond. Thank you, Jeffrey Harris. End of the letter. Our lawyer, Ken McCallion, responds as follows. It was on Thursday, last week, on Friday, Our lawyer responds as follows. Mr. Harris, you have not identified any basis for a motion to dismiss for lack of subject matter jurisdiction. Nor do we think that there is any basis for such a motion. We strongly suggest, therefore, that in order to avoid any further delays in this litigation, which was filed on January 5th, 2017, the more preferable course of action would be to file a notice of appearance and answer on behalf of Germany, which would permit us to proceed as expeditiously as possible to a resolution of the litigation. Our clients, as always, continue to remain open to any reasonable settlement proposal or procedure that would allow them to directly participate in the ongoing discussions between the governments of Germany and Namibia, and which is reasonably designed to lead to a just settlement and restorative justice for the plaintiffs and the Vahenero and Nama communities. Very truly yours, Kenneth McKellion. Those were the communications between the two lawyers. Instead of following the good advice of this learned and experienced counsel, Mr. Harris simply continued to file his motion for dismissal. End result was that on Tuesday, the judge in the case, Judge Swain, issued an order terminating and striking Germany's motion to dismiss, which means he dismissed the motion by Germany challenging our suit or our complaint. The first attempt by Germany, well, they did file a motion to dismiss our case. So through the US lawyer, they did submit to US jurisdiction, didn't they? In their first attempt to throw us out, got a bloody nose. Because they did not follow even the basic technical rules of following the rules of the court. The court noted that Germany's counsel had violated the local rule requiring the moving party's lawyer to consult the opposing counsel. In this case, Ken McKellion's firm, our lawyer's firm, to try to resolve the issues before the motion is filed. Germany's lawyers only sent our lawyer an email, as I have read now, giving me the option of withdrawing our complaint, our case, which of course our lawyer declined, pointing out that there's no basis for such a withdrawal. So Germany must go back to the drawing board, follow the rules, and see whether they can mount a proper challenge. Germany has now, through this attempt, added insult to the injury by demanding that the complaint be withdrawn and dismissed without complying with the court's reasonable requirements that counsel first attempt to resolve the issues arising in the case, such as the demand for participation in the negotiations through discussions between counsel. So Germany's arrogance continues, even in the United States, towards the court. Germany is now treating the judge's rules with the same degree of contempt that they have responded to our reasonable overtures for participation in the negotiations. The United States court does not seem to be impressed with Germany so far. The order of the court is available to the press. Maybe you can, if you distribute it to the press, so that they can read it for themselves. Come again. The email between the two lawyers, or you also want the confidential things are also in the hard copy. Yeah, I made it public, I read it to you, you must be fast. You are journalists, you are trained to take notes, like my good friend here in front of me. She's an expert in this, doing these things.
Journalists want evidence.
Journalists want evidence. The evidence is here, I can give it to you, you can look at it, but you must give it back to me. I'm not going to give you hard copies. Ah, I see one of them is now taking out what's left to me. Take a copy. You can take a, what's the name, a photograph with your cell phone, but I'm not going to give you a what's the name. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, this is what I wanted to share with you, that there is nothing in limbo. The fight is on. It's for real. Guys. It's for real. And the German ambassador must advise his government that they can't have their bread and eat it. If you have decided to eat the bread, you can't still hope that you must still hold it in your head. There's no such thing in life. If you decide that you are going to be a sovereign state and refuse not to subject yourself to the jurisdiction of the United States, then that's it. But you can't take that position and then at the same time decide to instruct lawyers to go and participate in the legal process in the United States because somehow at one level it suits you. Because you think, here I'm likely to get some favorable judgment and run away with it. It's like saying, I'm going to play the game of football provided I'm declared the winner of the game. But if I lose the game, then what? Then what do you say? Then I did not play the game. I was not in the game. I did not participate in the game. So please tell the ambassador to advise his government that when your mommy is pregnant with you in the tummy, you are there, 8-9 months, you must decide either you stay in your mommy's tummy and play by those rules, or you get out. And when you decide to get out of your mother's tummy and come into this world, you play by the rules of this world. And in this world, there are rules that govern relations between people on this earth. Period. Civilized people in this world are governed by certain rules. So you can't decide that mommy's tummy is okay, I stay here, but if it gets too crowded there, I want out, but I don't want to play by the rules outside of mommy's tummy. You're either sovereign, or you don't subject, and if you subject, there are rules of this world, including the court of the United States. Now we have instructed counsel in the US. That is subjecting yourself to the jurisdiction of the courts in the United States. There's no other way for it. Or is there? Well, you lost the first round, Mr. Chief Propagandist, in case you didn't hear it properly. That's what the order says. There's more to come. I guarantee you. We have eminent lawyers. We have prepared our case. We have the bones of our ancestors right there in New York to bring in front of the court, if you mind, to see them. And we have on quotas orders, extermination orders, including original ones signed by von Trotter. The ones that the Brigitte Lausu of this world and other historians that wanted to defend your criminalities were even trying to doubt. Because the signed ones were hidden away, nowhere to be found for years. When we dug them out, we found them. In a Chihiro signed, in Netherlands, sound signed, in English signed, by von Trotter. They are now in New York with our lawyer. We are ready to find you, to fight you, centimeter by centimeter, all the way. If you thought it was going to be cheap, it ain't going to be cheap. Even if you decide now that you will withdraw your lawyers, you will stay away, and the case is gonna, I don't know what happened. Frankly speaking, we don't care. Because to us, the legal route is simply one avenue of struggle. If it doesn't yield the results we want, there's a peaceful way of achieving a settlement. German citizens, hear me loud and clear. We are ready to take on your government at a different level. Until we achieve this. The only issue is that by the end of the day, the settlement terms for you going to be progressively worse. But for our people, the victory is certain. That is for sure. The legal road is for us, but simply plan B. Having tried direct negotiations as plan B, we still have a plan C and a plan D, probably even plan A.